Welcome back to Hot Copy. We're talking with Senator Serge Osmena on the Senate probe into the supposedly anomalous DBP loan. Some questions, Senator, from Facebook. Vicky TD asks, isn't Ongpin's loan one of the most, I'll handle that first, that's a good one, most profitable loans of DBP?
No, okay. Definitely not. It was given to him at 2% over...
That's so low, huh? Yeah.
Yes, at 2% over 180-day rates.
Yeah.
When what was normal for them was 5% over. So how can it be very profitable?
Yeah, but there must be a reason why it's given at 2%. I mean, if it's a big loan, does that cover it or no? No? So all other loans pay 5%?
5 to 8 over.
Yeah, 2% is pretty low. Okay, now loans of DBP, another one, the continuation. Why don't you investigate the other loans that are still unpaid? Why not investigate Buddy Zamora's loan?
We will be looking into that. Right now, the resolution of the Senate that had been filed by Senator Ping Lacson and approved unanimously by the Senate were to investigate this group of loans.
Okay.
So I'm not tasked to look into the other loans.
Yeah.
But I think that with that suggestion, we really should.
Yeah.
Also.
But do you understand, Senator, why let's say if this is an employee or a layman, they're saying, why hit on someone who actually pays their loans? There's so many people, wealthy people in this society. Some of them are elected officials, which
yes.
I don't want to name.
Yes.
Write off their loans. And here's Bambi Ongpin. Fine, he gets it in a day. It's a special favor. He earns a lot of money, but he paid the loan.
Yeah.
Okay.
You know, after the fall of the Marcos regime, what happened was that the banks, PNB, DBP, SSS, GSIS, and several commercial banks were left hanging because of the amount of bad loans that they had on their books, that they were swallowed. Associated Bank collapse, General Bank collapse, Union Savings Bank collapse,
yeah.
And earlier Bancom Development.
Okay.
So when the investigation started, they started on the loans that had not been paid.
Okay.
But essentially, when you're giving out behest loans, these are a violation of what are known as prudent and safe banking practices.
And I think the world, you have to contextualize
yes.
it. The world has changed. They won't tolerate it anymore following the financial collapse in the
Correct.
U.S. recently. Yeah.
But even before that
yeah.
in the U.S., they would not tolerate this. You go okay. to here, remember the movie Wall Street?
I do.
Well, that was 15 years
yes,
ago, and the
yes.
guy got arrested
Correct.
And got
okay.
in jail.
Uh-huh.
That's insider trading.
Mm-mm.
So what we're saying is that we have to maintain the integrity of our banking system. Hindi po pwede na pwede ninyo isugal yung pera ko pagkatapos sasabihin mo, binayaran ko naman. No, but if you violated the rules of the Banco Central ng Pilipinas on what is safe and sound
yes.
banking practice, we're only doing this to protect the
yes.
deposits of the investor in the bank.
Okay, all right. No, you kind of make sense in that way, because if you put it on layman's terms, if everybody in this office knew that Manny Pangilinan was buying it at 21, then the cameraman would have bought a Philex share. You know what I mean?
I would have bought it.
That's the
20
point.
Pesos and 99 cents.
You know what I mean? You know, it didn't benefit everybody else. It was
Correct.
Just for a certain group of people. Now, Ricardo Principe Jr. is asking you, totoo ba na yung loan ni Mr. Buddy Zamora na allegedly ilang beses nang ni-restructure, hindi pa rin makabayad? At totoo bang tao niya yung bagong president ng DBP? Great questions.
I'll be honest with you. I've never met Buddy Zamora in my life, but
yeah.
I know his brother Ronnie because Ronnie was my classmate for 8 years in La Salle. And I also happen to know Manny, but I've never met Buddy.
Okay.
Or I don't remember ever having met Buddy. Number two, I also don't know who Pepo Nunez was until I met him for the first time about a month ago.
Okay.
I've heard that he used to work for Buddy Zamora. I didn't know that before, and there was no
yeah.
objection to it anyway. Thirdly, I do not know the status of Buddy Zamora's banks with the DBP.
Okay.
We're not allowed to look into that.
Yeah, but you will investigate.
If there's a resolution, definitely.
Okay.
Because
All
that's
right.
an order from the Senate.
Uh-huh. All right, we have 3 minutes left, but I want to ask you, there will be another hearing. This is not yet over. Who are you inviting, and what exactly do you want to find out?
Well, we want to nail down, number one, certain facts, and they're just too many to enumerate now. Senator Enriquez started by testing the credibility of Mr. David.
Okay.
And I think that he kind of punched several holes in Mr. David's story.
Yeah.
No? We will be calling others. We're waiting for Bobby Ongpin.
Do you think Bobby Ongpin will show up? If I were him, I think he should show up.
I think he should. I mean, we've been waiting for him since the first hearing.
He can answer every question that you can throw.
Yeah. We would like to have him over, because then the members of the committee will also try to test his credibility. You know, this is a technique lawyers use, and I'm not a lawyer, but they probe. They ask you several types of questions to determine whether you're being consistent.
Okay. All right. Number three, how important is it that Manny Pangilinan goes to the hearing?
I already said this in advance 2 weeks ago. I said, I will ask Manny Pangilinan one question. Mm-hmm. Did you tell anybody in advance what price you're willing to pay?
Yeah. And you expect him to tell the truth?
I will not say that Manny Pangilinan will lie.
Okay. Now, what will the Filipino people get out of this hearing? I mean, you know what some people are saying? Ano lang yan eh, yan yung away ng mga mayayaman. Sila-sila lang naman kumita dyan eh. May makukulong ba dyan? May mababalik mang pera? Eh, kumita na lahat sila sa shares na yan.
That perspective is right. Nobody has ever been tried for insider trading in this country, much less gone to jail.
Okay.
But we want to put somebody in jail.
Okay.
For the first time. Now, it all depends upon the will, the credibility of the Aquino administration. However, let me say this. The Filipino people will benefit from these series of hearings by knowing that people are watching. Shenanigans will be exposed. Corrections will be made to the laws. And there will be a tightening up of enforcement by the Banco Central, the COA, the Department of Finance. Yeah. And we will be better off because of this.
Okay. All right. Thank you so much, Senator. And I think to contextualize it, I think the public has to know that there are DBP employees, I think two of them, that filed the case against DBP for the questionable 660 million loan prior to the hearing. I think this was months before the hearing that they just felt the loan was questionable themselves. Will you invite those two people to the Senate?
They have been invited.
They've been already there.
They're always present. This is Popoy Del Rosario, the president, and Pepo Nunez, the chairman.
Okay.
They filed the case with the ombudsman.
Okay. All right. Now, that's Head Start today, everyone. I hope you learned something, and we tried to simplify some of the issues you've been watching in the Senate that you'll be able to understand better and make better choices. The full replay of Hot Copy, Senator Sergio Osmena's interview, is at 6:30 p.m. tonight on ANC. Watch it in full and understand exactly what went on. Have a nice day, everyone. See you again tomorrow.